Okay, let's continue. So now we consider very important thing. Conditions of potentiality of a vector of a vector field. So given a vector field, a field F of R, which is P of X, Y, Z, Q of the same, in three dimensions also R of the same. How to know if it is potential? No, first, here we can ask two opposite questions. Given a field, we know that it is potential. Which conditions are necessary? So, what are the properties of the field such that every potential field satisfies these properties? Yes, it is one problem. Other question is which conditions are sufficient for potentiality. So, if a field has this property, then it is potential. Yeah? I mean, properties simpler than the definition that integral, say, along every closed curve is zero, for example. Now, let us consider. So, suppose. Consider first two-dimensional f of x1, xy equals p xy q of xy is potential. This means that for some function f p of xy equals df dx of xy, q of xy equals df dy of xy. And suppose that p and q are differentiable functions. Now we always suppose that all necessary derivatives exist and are continuous. Then consider dp dy. Yes? So p itself is df dx equals d2f dy dx. Yes? If you substitute here, equals fyx. And on the other hand, consider dq dx. So they are crisscrossing. P differentiate with respect to y and q with respect to x. It is d2f first dx dy. So first we differentiate with respect to y and then x equals fxy. So, by the Clairaut theorem, f xy is identically equal to fyx. I explained without real proof that for any function such that it has first and second derivatives which are continuous, we have that these mixed derivatives are equal, identically equal. So it is the same differentiate first with respect to x and then to y, and or first with respect to y and then respect to x, the same. So if you substitute here, we have dp dy of x as function of x is identically equal to dq dx. Yeah? So if you look at a field in the two-dimensional field, yes, in the plane, which is defined by two coefficients, p and q. First, if you ask, is it a potential or not? First thing is to find these derivatives and see if they are equal, then there is a chance that it is potential. If they are not equal, then no chance. This field is not potential. Now, for example, say p equals ex cosine y, q equals ex sine y. Let us see. So f equals pq. Equals p of x, y, I plus q of x, y, j. Yes? How to check? Is this field potential or not? So we find dp dy p ex equals minus ex sine y dq dx equals ex sine y. They are different, yeah? So f is not potential. And now if you consider p equals ex sine y, q equals ex cosine y, yeah? Consider this case, this field with these components. Then dp dy equals ex cosine y, dq dx equals ex also cosine y. So this case dp dy equals dq dx. And we can see easily that this field is potential. Now how to find potential function? Let us guess. This is p is derivative respect to x, q is derivative to y. So if you take f of xy equals ex sine y, df dx equals ex sine y df dy equals ex cosine y. It is exactly p and q equals p, and this is equals q. So really this vector field with these components is potential, and this this is not potential because we have different things. Okay. Now what happens in three dimensions? Again, how can we see when the field is not potential? So what is the necessary condition of potentiality? So P F equals P I plus Q J plus RK. No, P, Q, and R are functions of X, Y, Z. Then P of X, Y, Z equals df dx. Q equals df dy. R is df dz. Yeah? Then we can form the following thing. Dp dy equals f yx. Dq dx equals fxy. Yeah? They should be equal. Dp dy minus dq dx equals 0. Now, dp dz equals fxz. Yeah, first differentiate with respect to x, then to d. Dr dx. So R is df dz, and then differentiate with respect to x, equals fxz. They are equal again. So dp dz should be equal, or minus d r dx should be 0. And the last is dq dz minus dr dy. So q is df dy and then dz, r is df dz, and then differentiate y. So it is f zy minus f yz. It should be also 0. So we have three identities instead of one in two dimension case. We have identity 1, 2, 3. Three identities. If you look a little bit at this identity, you see something familiar. In fact, these are three components of curl of vector f. Let me show it. Curl F, or nabla cross F, is the given by this determinant I J K D dx D dy D dz P Q R. Yeah. Ой, I'm sorry. Let me take another pen. They are going so fast. Equals, let me write it. With I, it is R Y minus Q Z I plus, so we have the P Z minus R X. P Z minus R X J plus the last is QX minus PY. QX minus PY K. Yes? So RY minus QX. RY minus, where is? RY minus QZ. Here, RY minus DQZ, this is zero, so it is this. Yeah, no, with the opposite sign. This should be zero. This dp dz minus dr dx, it is this. It is zero. And dq dx minus dp dy, it is this. Yes? Identically zero. No, it is vector zero. Each of them is zero. So the conclusion, if F is potential, then curl F is zero. We have already one moment. It is in U. So this is, it is in U. So when you are assigned to find a linear integral of some vector field in two or in three dimensions, then first of all you have to check if this field is potential. The criterion for potentiality in two dimensions. No, in fact, in two dimensions, we can also consider the third dimension and consider vector field in three-dimensional space. Why I consider them almost interchangeably? Because if you have f of x, y equals p I, P of X, Y, I, plus Q of X, Y, J, yeah? We can consider this also as a vector field in three dimensions, in 2D. In 3D, you consider F of X, Y, Z equals P of X, Y I plus Q of X Y J the same. Now, if you wish, you can add plus zero times K. Zero times K. So the same vector field with the same formula. It defines also vector field in three dimension. In fact, it is vectors are all in the xy plane and do not depend on z. Yeah. Any two-dimensional vector field can be regarded as three-dimensional, which simply does not depend on z, and vectors are directed in xy plane. Now the question. If a vector field satisfies, yes, let me introduce, yes, and in this case, a curl of this vector field, which has the this form, is, let us find its curl, it is important. I, j, k, dx, dy, dz, p, q, 0. So, with e, dy of 0, dz of q. Q does not depend on 0, q depends on x, y. So, it is 0 times I. Here, dp dz, it is 0 because p depends only on x, y, does not depend on z. Dx 0, it is also 0, so remains 0 times j. And the last with k, dx q, dq dx minus dyp dp dy k. Yes, so here is only one coefficient, one component of a curl of this vector field, which is two-dimensional vector field, which we simply defined in three dimensions by the same formula. And it has only one component. This component is exactly what was in the condition of potentiality. So if this component is zero, if a vector field, two-dimensional vector field, was potential, and the potential function f depends also on x and y, then its curl is zero. So now let me give a definition. We have to somehow call this vector field. Definition. A vector field F of R is called irrotational if curl F is zero. The zero means that it's vector zero. Yeah? And our theorem, which was is already proved, potential field is irrotational. Every potential field is irrotational. And immediately the question, is it true that opposite, that if a field is irrotational, it is potential? To some extent, it is true. In general, not. But to some extent, it is true. So let me give a definition. This depends on in which domain we consider. Previously, you know, we mostly considered vector field defined in the whole plane or in the whole three-dimensional space. Such field, it is a simplest case, and in this case, conjecture is true that if a field is irrotational, this means that its curl is zero, then this field is potential, so there exists a potential. But in more complicated domains, it can be not true. So I give a definition. Domain, D in plane is simply connected. It is new term. If it contains no holes. What does it mean? So simply connected the whole plane. It simply connects. There is no holes in the plane. Half plane. Yes, imagine, say, upper half of the plane. There is no holes there, so it is simply connected. Interior of a circle. This domain is also simply connected because there is no holes. Now, what is not simply connected? This domain with hole, yes, or we can consider domain with two holes, yeah, it contains holes, the whole plane without one point. So we make a pinhole at the origin. Yeah, so our domain is all the plane, but it does not contain this point. It is very small hole, just one point, but it can be essential. And so on. In three-dimensional case domains, there are much more domains, types of domains. Let me topic for 3D. For in 3D we consider simple domains like the whole space, half space, interior of a ball, interior of a cube. It's enough for us. Yes. Now I would like to consider one example, which is, I would say, deep, simple but deep. And it will show us what can happen. example, f of xy equals minus y divided by x square plus y square, x divided by x square plus y square. So this vector field is defined everywhere but at the origin. So it is exactly this case that we have a pinhole at the origin, and the vector field is defined everywhere beyond this point. Yes? First of all, let us see if this vector field is irrotational. P equals minus y x square plus y square, q equals x divided by x square plus y square. Dp dy equals x square plus y square square, and here dp dy x square minus x square plus y square plus y times 2y equals minus x square minus y square plus 2y square plus y square divided by x square plus y square square. Dq dx, again, x square plus y square, and here x square plus y square minus x times 2x equals minus x square plus y square divided by x square plus y square square. They are equal. Yeah? So this means that dp dy minus dq dx identically zero. No, everywhere outside this origin where this field is not defined. No, when we approach this origin, denominator grows fast, decreases faster than numerator, so this vector field goes, its modulus goes to infinity. So no wonder that it is not defined at this point. No, so this field F is irrotational. Great. Now let us say if it is irrotational, first of all, let us find its integral. No, the simple contour is this circle, unit circle around the origin. C x equals cosine t, y equals sine t. T between 0 and 2 pi. So integral over this contour, f dot dr equals integral from 0 to 2 pi. So parameter is t. Cosine t, so the first component is y minus y equals cosine t minus sin t. Yeah? Divided by x square sin square t plus cosine square t times x prime, it is minus sin t. No, dt I will write later. Now the second plus the next second component is cosine t, sine square t plus cosine square t times dy, y is sine times cosine t. Dt. Now this is one. This we have sine square plus cosine. It is one equals integral from zero to pi dt. So all this is one equals two pi, which is different from zero. Yeah. So something is wrong. So this vector field is not potential. If it were potential, it would be zero. So something happens with this vector field. On the other hand, consider the following function. So I consider a function which looks like its potential. This function is the following. It is x, y, and it is this angle phi. Phi of x, y equals arctangens y over x. X more than zero. So this function is defined, well defined for x positive. Yeah, so that we could divide by x. No, okay, d phi d x equals 1 divided by 1 plus y square divided by x square times minus y divided by x square. It is derivative of this equals if you multiply numerator by x square, so here is x square plus y square, and here you have minus y. After all, now you can check it yourself. D phi dy equals again 1 plus y square x square times 1 over x. 1 over x. No, instead of this, we write 1 plus y square x square times x divided by x square equals x divided by x square plus y square. So it is P, and this is Q. Yeah. So our function, our vector field is potential here. This potential, phi, this potential function. So our vector field F of x, y equals gradient of phi if x more than zero. So it is good only in this right half plane. Now this angle is defined farther, and here in the upper plane we can also define this angle here everywhere, and here this angle phi is equal to arc cotangens of x divided by y. If y positive, yes? So this angle, you can see easily see that in the upper half plane is defined by the same, by this formula. And if you differentiate it, which let me not do, you have the same, that here also this vector field f is gradient of this function. Yes, so it is the same function. Here it was in the right half plane, it was defined by this function. In the upper half plane, by this function. In the overlapping in the first quadrant, both these functions give the same result. So here is no ambiguity. Now, if you go to the left half plane, here and even here, we have the following phi. Phi equals again arctangens of y over x, but y over x here is the same of y over x here. So it gives this arctangens gives this angle. So we have to add pi plus pi. Yes. And here, in the it is from when x less than zero. And now here in y less than zero, here yes, this angle, this is phi. Here phi equals arc cotangens of x divided by y, yes, but it is not this angle, because we got formula gives this angle. So we have to add again plus pi, plus pi. So after all, if you, it is one and the same function which geometrically is defined by this angle. So after we make the full turn, we return here to the positive real axis with instead of zero, we start with zero, it grows, 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 and here this angle becomes 2 pi. Yes? So the deep fact is that this function angle, in fact, it is not a single function. Yes, it is, if you go on, it grows, linearly grows, grows, now it becomes 2 pi. If you continue, it will grow farther if you want to keep it continuous, yes? So it grows beyond 2 pi and so on. If you rotate our vector left, then it decreases. So in fact, this is not a single valued function, infinite many values. So if you have some value phi of this vector, phi plus 2 pi is another branch, phi plus 4 pi is another, phi minus 2 pi is another, and so on. So this means that we have to somehow restrict our domain so that this function phi be single valued. We have to take, say, half plane, yes, or maybe a little more than half plane, but we cannot take the whole plane. Therefore, our domain, no, domain should be something like this. It should have no holes, yes, and this function phi should be defined everywhere and be continuous and have continuous derivatives, first and second. Then it will be fine. Yeah. So this is already some delicate mathematical situation. Now I will formulate the theorem, which I would not prove now. If a field F is irrotational in a simply connected domain, it is potential. In this domain, so in with this restriction that we consider in simply connected domain without holes, these two properties are equivalent, irrotational and irrotational and potential. Yes. And now I wanted to consider briefly, it is more more computational thing. The following problem. Suppose F is an irrotational field. How to find its potential? F of R. Yeah. So if it is a rotational, it is potential by the theorem which was written here, and I think you have to believe me that this theorem is true. How to actually find potential? How to actually find potential? How to find potential? No, let me show you the procedure on two simple examples. First two-dimensional examples. F x y equals 4x cube plus 6x square y. Two x cube plus 6y square. Okay. So it's the first component, the second. So p equals 4x cube plus 6x square y. Q equals 2x cube plus 6y square. So dp dy equals 6x square, because this does not contain y. Dq dx equals, it is 2, 6x square. This does not depend on x. So this means that f is irrotational. Defined in all the plane, the whole plane does not contain holes, yeah, so it is simply connected, hence it is potential. Okay, if even this potential, there exists F xy such that P equals dF dx, Q equals dF dy. Yeah? So we have to find F. So we have dF dx of xy equals p. P equals 4x cube plus 6x square y. So partial derivative is obtained as just ordinary derivative when you fix y, partial derivative with respect to x. So if you have derivative of a function as a function of x, we restore this function by integration. So this means that f of xy equals integral 4x square x cube plus 6xy x square y dx plus c equals no integral x to the 4 plus 2x cube y plus c xy. So we found this function on a line parallel to x-axis, y is constant, and c is arbitrary constant, or I would say unknown constant. And in fact it is not a constant, because this constant is maybe different on different lines parallel to x, yeah? On this line it can be different constant. So in standard constant, we write function which depends on y, g of y. Yeah? So we find the function f of xy equals x to the 4 plus 2x cube y plus g of y. Now we have to find g of y. We have the second equation that d f dy equals q of xy. We have this function. Let us differentiate it with respect to y. df dy. We have this form. If, so this is does not depend on y. It is 2x cubed plus g prime of y. Yes, g depends, but what was q? Let me recall it. So q equals 2x cubed plus 6y squared. So equals 2x cubed plus 6y squared. So this cancels. G prime of y equals 6y squared. G of y equals integral 6y squared dy equals 2y cubed plus c. Now c is honest constant. Yes, no, arbitrary. So if you substitute it into our function f, xy it is what obtained by integration, plus g of y is here. Then f of xy equals x to the 4 plus 2x cubed y plus 2y cubed plus c. No, we cannot see do anything else because the c does not affect the p and q. P and q are derivatives, partial derivatives of this function, and anyway, partial derivative of c is zero. So it is what remains. And then that's it. So where is here condition of that this field is irrotational, that its criss-cross derivatives are equal. Condition is here. So if you try to apply this to arbitrary vector field, then immediately you will see. So what happened here? That g prime of y, after all, is a function of y only. And for arbitrary vector field, we have g prime of y is a function of x and y, and nothing will work out. Yeah. So here we will be crushed. That's it. So this is the procedure. Now let me consider the last example. It is three-dimensional example. F of x, y, z equals 3x squared y x cube plus 6y squared z. And the third, 2y cube minus 3z square. So we have this vector field in three space. First of all, we have to check that it is irrotational. To this end, we write its curl is this determinant I J K dx dy dz, and here 3x square y x cube plus 6y square z, and the last is let me write this 2y cube minus 3z square. Yeah, so we have this determinant which is equal, so with I d dy of 2y square minus 3, so it is 6 y square minus d dz 6y square with I plus. Now with j dz, here we have 0 because this does not depend on z, dx of something which does not depend on x, 0 times j, and with k it is dx dx is cube 3x square here, and here dy minus 3x square k, which is 0. All components are 0. So this vector field is irrotational. F is irrotational. If it is irrotational, then there exists a function f of x, y, z such that p, I will write df dx is the first, 3x square y, df dy equals x cube plus 6 y square z, and the df dz equals 2y cube minus 3z square. Okay, now let's find this function. So df dx is 3x square y. So f of x, y, z equals integral 3x square y dx plus c constant, but this constant depends on y and z because we fix y and z and integrate only in the direction of x. So that is g of yz. Integral is the following. 3x square, it is x cube y plus g of yz. Now we have to differentiate f by y. And to find g of yz, so that this satisfied. So df dy, let's differentiate this, equals x cube plus dg of yz dy, and this is equal, should be equal to q, x cube plus 6 y square z. this cancels and remains dg of yz dy equals 6 y square z. G of yz equals integral 6 y square z dy plus constant. And this time, this constant we integrate with respect to y, x, it all does not depend on x. Now we are only in yz plane. So the constant depends on z because z, we fix z plus say h of z equals 6 y integral 6 y square, it is 2 y cube z plus h of z. Yeah. Now to find h of z, we have first of all to add this to our function f. So f of x y z equals x cube y, it is here, plus g. G is 2 y cube, it is cube z plus h of z. So this is the form of our function. Now we have to find h of z. We have the last equality, that its derivative with respect to z equals to this. So df dz equals, differentiate, this does not depend on z, 2y cube plus h prime of z equals 2y cube plus 3z square. Yeah? Okay, and now so from here we see that h prime of z equals 3z square. H of z equals integral of 3z square dz plus c. This time it is almost constant. It is, does not depend on anything. Equals z cube plus c. Now it remains to include this into our function. And we have our function. Let me draw it here. F of x, y, z equals x cube y, I take from here, plus 2 y cube z plus z cube plus c. So this potential c is unavoidable because we, in fact, we honestly don't know what is c. For any c, we have the same gradient of this function because the derivative of constant is zero. So this is why we find this function, and we can find the integral over any contour C, f dot dr, if you are given this. And the examiner can be so nasty that he draws some tricky contour, I don't know, some spiral, something like this, and says, please find integral along this contour. And it will be really tricky, but in fact it is simply f of b minus f of a, where contour goes from the point A to the point B. Yes, so you don't need to make further integration. You have just to follow this procedure. No, this procedure is a little long, but I hope you will master it and you will have additional exercises in this. Yes, by the way, if you took previous course in engineering 213, ordinary equation, you will easily recognize that it is the same as solution of what is called the exact equations. So we are talking about more or less one and the same thing in two different courses in a little different language. No such things happen. No, okay, I think it is more than enough for now, so have a good time, please, if you can. Bye.